to all of us and tips. Come and put it in this way, not that way. Okay. Safe. Took a bit long, but got through. Exit. Cool, so we finally touched down after a mad delayed flight. Ain't got no baggage to pick up because it's all hand luggage. Exit doors broken.
Yeah.
And that man's just at the train station. It's looking kind of weird. You know, daylight, early seats. Interesting. Amsterdam Central. I'm thinking if I should just wait for the last one and just get a direct and straight there. Mad. How long is that even anyway? That's quite a bit of a wait, like maybe 15 minutes. Try to see if there's any seats at these Amsterdam train stations. Or do we just have metal planks? So far, it just seems to be diagonal metal planks. Okay. Seems like people's coming from work and all this stuff. She must have been on a late shift. And obviously, this is these trains. I don't even know if they got Wi-Fi on them. All of that. I want to cross back over, people. I don't really like walking too close to water. That's the honest truth. Somebody might feel frivolous one day and try to push my in and think it's bent, but I might have to come on back and come outside and button it up. With mountain. I'll leave my head on the floor. Yeah, she told me the right way, you know. I just come under this one bridge, everything started to look familiar now. Still, it's crazy. Crazy. So now basically I'm in the city, I just came out of the wrong exit. Bear in mind, guys, come out the fucking right exit when you come out of City Central. Yeah? Otherwise you'd be going towards fucking West Amsterdam. Yeah. Cool. It's coming towards the city parts now. Trying not to get run over, trying to find the best way to cross. What is the best way to cross? I'll probably say that way. There's not much people around there. Interesting. You have to be careful, bro. What's this? I can hear something squeaky still, but anyway, I just wanted to give a little update. Update. I'm in Dam. Landed all safe. Yeah, man. Just here. Got a little balcony too, so I can smoke in that. So that's calm, I'll make that loud in a minute. Got my food on the way. Got my room in there. Yeah, I just want to give you guys a quick little rundown of my journeys. Obviously, I landed in Dam today. I had to come a day early based on the company changing flight times and stuff. So I had to come out a day early, and obviously I had to incur the cost of booking a hotel, which I wasn't too upset about. And now this is the hotel I'm just chilling in now. It's nice to have my own space. You know, little balcony thing there so I can go out and smoke as well, so can't complain. But obviously, this is after the massive delay, after sitting on a plane for like over an hour of not moving. Didn't hear any reasons as to why this was the case until over an hour in, where the staff decided to tell us that they had a problem closing the cargo doors. And they called somebody half an hour ago to come and help, but they haven't turned up yet. It was a bit fucked, but now I'm here just waiting for my munch to come true, because obviously I've only eaten once today. I'm gonna say I'm starving, but I'm definitely hungry, but the most thing I can do with right now is a drink. You know what I mean? I got to the airport, coming here, Luton Airport, spilled a bottle of water on my crotch, fam. Big man thing. Whole 1.5 bottle of water to fling away. Do you get what I'm saying? All spilled on my crotch. Lucky I bought a fucking spare shorts and boxers I'll change into. But yeah, initially, so far it's been a mare. But I managed to get a bit loud. Don't know if it's on me right now. No, it's not even there. Some cherry thing. Red cherry berry was good. So I'm about to go smoke that, obviously. Just waiting for the food to turn up. Gonna smoke that after. Got a certain coffee shop that I went to. I forgot what it was called. I think it was Barney's I went to, you know. Barney's, I'm looking at the menu. Gelato, Skittles. The whole shebang, you know what I mean? So I might have to go there and speak to man tomorrow and see what I can do. But yeah, I'm gonna try some stuff tomorrow, see what else. Might have to bring a little cocktail, back in man's grinder still. Just like little bits, not really gonna bring too much. It's not worth it for me to get bagged for bringing over crumbs, bro. Do you get what I'm saying? Why get bagged for bringing over crumbs?
That's out here still. Main road, just collected our food. Just smoking some loud at the minute. Just outside the hotel, keeping it light, keeping it quiet. You know, smoking loud.
Obviously, the food's come. Just had some of my loud. Loud, baby, because you're smoked. Let me have some red cherry berry, something still. I'm not gonna lie, it was loud still. But yeah, about the food.
I was thirsty, obviously I had to order two drinks. Got the chips and a burger.
And yeah, so obviously it's just a normal Coke, bro. What do you expect? But
here's the fries. They came already salted, lightly. It's good for me. And then over here we've got a burger. I'm not gonna lie, it's looking kind of decent for man still. Sorry, it's looking all rough, man. I ain't got no plates or no nothing out here, but shit. You know what I mean? This is takeaway, isn't it? Like, you need plates or?
This is the world and after still. You know, I'm feeling kind of knackered. Not gonna lie to you.
I have to go and get this breakfast from this place very shortly.
Yeah, I have to go and get breakfast and then check out in a bit. I've still got like maybe over an hour to do that. So wait till 10 o'clock, go downstairs, get breakfast at 10 o'clock. Around that. Get showered up now.
get my shit patterned up. I don't know what the temperature's gonna be staying to there. Maybe more of a tracking thing, to be honest. But yeah, man, it's looking alright out here still. I'm just gonna smart out loud in a sec. I'm just trying to pre what type of house this is, but I'm assuming they've just obviously bought the land, bought a house, and then maybe they've built off part in the back of the yard, maybe. So, of what last night looked like this morning. The actual views. I didn't really want to do it last night because it was all debatable. More like walking around fucking water in the dark and that shit, bruv. But now this. This is a beautiful view, bro. You know what I mean? Charles for his phone before he made me drop my phone in the rascal. Mad. I'm gonna have to sit there and just smoke one little zoo on it. I'm a quick one, like, I don't even know if I can do that, but I'm gonna do it anyway because this view, it's not a London view, this is something you don't really see in London. Yeah, you got the Thames on that, but oh, is that the same? I should even zoom in for this as well, but my camera's not good enough, not gonna lie. We're going to get into open water. Bruv, that looks live, man. Just sitting there chilling on the top end. Pause. That was heavy still. Machinery on that though. Mad. Never seen that shit before. And you got these, man. That's the okay. So, this is the more heavy duty thing, obviously. Feds need to come set, yeah, man. Obviously. Why are they stop, man? They stop, man, you know. Gave man a little whistle. Gave man a little whistle, turn away. Wait for him. Bloody hell. Where they going? Where they taking, man? Give him a stop check or what? My brother's got a red face as well, red in the face. Oh. They fully stopped, man, for real though. Big man thing, like, that's sad times. I can't record the whole thing because it's a bit fun. Do you know what? Fuck it, I am going to record the whole thing. I was going to say no, but I am not. Okay, so the fed just put man's leg on their boat. Obviously, I can't understand what they're saying. There's no chance of that. I'll just spark up my loot while I'm sitting there watching this shit. Fuck it. Let's zoom in a little piece. Obviously you won't be able to hear any more different still, but it's got the zoom on it, like. Sorry, got diverted. Anyway. Cruddy hell. Is he really showing man his ID and his fucking, his boat license, you know? Rascal. Man got stopped for real. Okay, this is a mad team. They're not gonna get back, let's be honest. He's got his little licenses and he's pulling out, showing to man as well. Trying to make sure no one robs me from behind when I'm doing this. Okay, see the distress on man's face, you know? Nah, I'm joking. But what's mad is that this fucking police boat was literally, you'll probably see the footage anyway, like, was sitting next to the fucking boat for time before it drove off.
No, do I have to cry because it's coming close? No, not really. Like, let me just do this. Like, it's better if anything.
Shit. Saves me from doing a mad thing trying to hold this, bro. You know what I mean? I'm already gonna talk for the whole thing. Like, I'm already gonna put the whole thing on YouTube. Like, there's a certain part that just becomes boring. Boy, who knows? Like, yeah, I might just have to cut it a bit and then just carry on.
Thank you guys for watching A Day in Amsterdam Part 1. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to see Part 2, comment below. And don't forget, like and subscribe to the team.